Hey guys, Roger here from Roger's Rigs. I got something to say about pressure ridges. It's really fun to ice fish. It's really sad to die. So we try to avoid that every way we possibly can. And I've got a couple points here. If you come up to a pressure ridge, there are some serious things to be looking for. The biggest one, this one represents well, is right here. It's these cracks behind the main crack. This one's nice and obvious. You wouldn't jump across there onto there because there's a chance, especially if this softens up a little bit more, of it tabletopping. Look at this one here. See this big crack that runs out here? The last thing you want to do, and I nearly had this happen with myself, one of my friends. We came up to a pressure ridge and we jumped onto the other side. It was like a 1 foot jump. And the whole thing, a section like that, tipped. Whoa! That was scary. Particularly, you know, imagine if that thing tipped enough, dropped down, slid through, and popped back up. And there you are, no longer ice fishing productively. So you can see this spot where we chose to cross, it's a place where there is no back crack on either side. And if you walk, stay away from a ways, but walk up and down and try to find that strategic place. There's also a risk, you know, you go across these things, you're out there all day, you come back, especially this is March, this is when things are soft, the edges are moving, and things can pull away. You could come back and now it's a 12-foot opening instead of a 2-foot opening. So it's really key at this time of year to proceed with extreme caution and to be looking for these back cracks. It could save your life. So, thanks for watching. Check out all our other videos. We have a lot of videos on how to ice fish, how to make this contraption here, which we're pulling off right now, and how to catch perch. Check out Roger's Rigs, our channel, or Roger's Rigs, our website. Thanks for watching.